Welcome to the Varelros Online Showcase video, MIA edition. Today we are back at the refinery for what I thought would be a pretty decent solution to my exploding barrel problem. With the current setup, I did a first batch of a grand total of 180 barrels and only lost 4 of them. However, trying to load these 120 on, it's kinda not working the way I wanted to. So I thought this would be a very consistent solution, however it's still all over the place. So what's supposed to happen is what you just saw there, the barrel comes out, explodes right into this car over here. The second barrel, however, yeah, already a bit of a slouch, not going very far. And the third one, then, or the next one, then just notches it into any location. Maybe it has to do with how high the chute is, but yeah, it just seems to be very weird and inconsistent. Kinda sad. Anyways, what's supposed to happen is that they just fly into the car, which used to happen a bit more consistent, and I don't know what changed. And once they are in there, you can unload them onto this ramp over here. They will just tumble down into the actual position, right onto the correct car, and that would be it. Maybe it's something to do with this being, this having like a collision. Maybe even, no. It felt like once I'm standing here, it's kinda going correctly, but yeah, then it failed me already again, so who knows what's going on. It's weird. However, I found something that could maybe serve as a third solution to the problem, or at least as a third way to get everything started. Let's take a box here for example. Maybe I just need to put something else in here to purposefully glitch the items out, and that might actually help me get them more consistently into the spot where they would jump into the car. Of course, then also have to empty out the car again, but right now this doesn't seem to work anyways. So it might be a mix of having something in here to influence where they go, having a, just a car to catch them all, and then another custom ramp to put them right into the cars. It's kinda, it might be a solution that requires maybe multiple ones of these approaches in order to work out. Right now it just doesn't. And I'm not gonna test out this whole theory thing just while making the video. I'll be giving it a proper try afterwards. So yeah, what's the current state of this? And what a state it is, it's a state of disaster. But maybe in the future I'll get this done. However, there is also something else that may happen in the future. Because recently the developers made a poll on the Discord where they asked the community about whether or not they would like actual in-game support for moved industries. So that would be allowing people to move and duplicate industries, but also possibly giving them a free cam to move around by placing them and looking at them from multiple angles. Which would then of course also mean that they would have to fix this whole ordeal in order to make the refinery work with custom positioning. So I would be looking forward to that. The results of the poll were absolutely positive. I think it was like over 90% wanted that, and yeah, maybe it's even a case of them just testing out the waters while already having out or having worked out a few things there and only trying to maybe build a bit of hype or something like that. So who knows where it is in stage of development. One thing that kinda crept up on me regarding the different cars that I have and the trains that I'm building, I'm kinda switching over from having like multi-purpose trains to having purpose-built ones. For example, I used to have maybe some stay cars at the bottom of a valley where I would just occasionally come, pick them up and transport whatever I need to whatever industry I have. But right now, for example, most of my stay cars are just stuck here as a permanent fixture, since they are only meant to be transporting lumber to the refinery. And since the refinery cannot take too much lumber at a time, the rest of them are just sticking around as a bit of a storage solution. Wasn't meant to be the same case for the steel pipes here, but I was too enthusiastic with loading them on, and now they need to stick around here until I have enough space in the storage to even load everything there. But yeah, that's how it goes sometimes, especially if you're not planning out things properly. So that means that, especially for staykers, I'm kinda lacking that multi-purpose thing that can do or can go everywhere. Even been lending out a few of those cars for just multi-purpose things and later returning them. So I need a bit more money to maybe build some that are just for general deliveries here and there. I know that I have my bases covered for the refinery and the oil field, but I think the other locations, maybe not so much. I could maybe do with a purpose-built 16-car train for just the coal mine there, so having 16 of the cars for the base camp, but that still leaves out the iron works, both for the raw iron and the beams, and also maybe I need a few more down there for the rails at the coal mine. But that's something to do in the future. Another thing that I recently did, I just added a lot more cars to the sawmill. So this is another purpose-built train now, which is just sitting around here, loaded up with a lot of logs until I need them. I think it's 24 cars, so that's much more than I can even put into the lake at one time. But if I now do a lot of deliveries with stuff from the sawmill, once I have everything loaded up, I can just come onto this track, push the cars around a little in order to align a few with the platform, and then just drop off a few more logs without having to go back and forth between here and the logging camp all the time. So it's just gonna be a very long train every now and again, but not so many short ones all the time. So yeah, that should allow me to do other stuff more frequently and only do this occasionally, but in a more grand scale manner. Another thing that changed, that's quite a huge change to be clear, is that station over there. I completely ripped out the supply area from this place, and I guess it kind of looks a bit empty without the higher buildings back there, like the water tower and the. I think it was mostly the water tower, but also some other buildings. I think, yeah, I still have the firewood camp around here, just because it's very convenient, just putting one single quadwood car over here and then loading that and unloading onto that area right away. It's a bit of a cheat, but works out quite well. I should maybe just replace this at some point. But overall, the main bulk of the supply area has moved over to the other side of the river, and everything is there right now. Maybe I can just use a sizable attender. Oh no, I can't really do that. I want to use a tender, grab the stuff from over there and put all the firewood onto the other place, but that's really not how it works, and then again, firewood isn't really worth much, so I might just delete everything there and grab a few of the cardboard cars and just quickly deliver the stuff over here. Should be alright. So yeah, this is the start of a new station. When coming over the bridge, which is still the only way in and out, you have the choice between going to the left, which is the bypass line and also supply area stuff, or going to the right, where you go to the different sidings. Going to the left, you can either go to the front of the supply area, which is where you would get all the stuff that you need for your engine. So, water, coal, firewood, sand, everything is there and should all be good. The backside is more for delivering stuff to the firewood depot or the coaling tower. And going to the left here, you can go into the turntable. I remove the other turntable from the other side there and replace it with an engine shed, which will eventually, hopefully, finally house an. Yeah, that's a helper engine. Don't know which one I would go for, but something should be coming there at some point. Right now, I don't think I need one too urgently, so that's more on the back burner. For the different sidings, when you go to the second switch here, you can choose between just the general purpose sidings, of which there are four of varying length. And on the right side, you have what's a dedicated area for just the cordwood. Going on to the very right side, or the rightmost side, I mean, you would just park the train when it arrives with all the empties. And once you start filling up the cars, you would put them onto this track, which is a dead end. So there's an end of a track device somewhere further down the line, while this one actually allows the engine to drive straight off the track and go on to another siding in order to maybe refuel or just be out of the way. But this side is purpose-built to just get all of the cars from this track onto this one, and then you reassemble the train backwards, and the end of track device is actually there so that none of the cars can escape onto a different siding. But that's gonna be something that I'll be using rather soonish, and I think it should be alright. Once we go further down the line, we have the point where all the general sidings reconnect. I could maybe shove it a bit further down the line to make some of the tracks a bit longer. I mean, these are just the supply tracks anyway, so this doesn't matter, but these four lanes are just general sidings. I think they are long enough overall, but especially on this side, they are getting maybe a bit short. I'll see how far I can go with what I have here, and if I need something longer, I can extend these a little bit at least. But you also see that there's another track on this side, and that's actually part of a loop. I know loops in stations and all that aren't that realistic and all, but honestly, every time I go from the main line towards the oil field or back onto the main line from there, I always need to turn the engine around, maybe even the entire train in terms, when it comes to the supply train for the oil field. And I was kinda getting a bit tired of the process, so I decided just at the end of the line have a little turnaround and use that instead. So on this side, the only two tracks going further down the line are for the cordwood, as they need to be a bit longer. And on this end, I made something that's maybe a bit weird, but it's working out quite well. So first up, when staying on this track, you could just connect to the other track over there, so this is how you get your engine out of this area. So if I want the Twin Sea to be disconnected from the rest of the train, I just drive it a bit further, clear the switch and drive it out backwards and into the supply area to maybe turn it around or refuel. While the other track here is just again, this is just the end of line for the reassembled train to have a stopping area. However, if you go onto this switch here and turn onto this side, you go into the little loop that I just mentioned. It just goes across the river with a bit of an incline because this entire area is not really. It's not working out well with a full-size loop. I think this is like a 50-meter radius for the turn. So it's a bit on the tighter side, and I even had to move the mainland out of the way here. It does a little bit of a kink there in order to make space for the lower track. But this was the only way I could make this entire thing fit. Turned out to be working alright though. So before this would go a bit more straight-ish, and then kinda go halfway over that part of the track before reconnecting to the outside there. So this had to be switched up a little bit at least. But I think it turned out quite well. So afterwards you just go a tiny bit higher to clear this little part of the map. Would be nice to have a way to make a cut here, but can't really do much about that. Then go back over the river, this time around with a truss bridge. and then reconnect to the supply line. I wanted to kind of get onto somewhere on this part, and initially I wanted to start the loop at the end of of the other part of the track there, but that didn't work out, so I needed to do something like this, otherwise the loop just didn't have any space there. At least it should be way long enough to ensure that I can go there within another entire train without the station clogging up. Because if the train was too long, it could be that maybe the last car hasn't, or the back of the train hasn't vacated the final switcher before the beginning of the train comes back around. But that definitely cannot be the case with how this is all set up. So, should be alright. And yeah, I think that's it for this entire area. This took me a while. Made a little building here as a workshop. This, of course, being the Undertaker building, I just, yeah, put a board in front of a sign. Would actually be nice if one of if we had multiple of these custom text signs, like this, and one of them would maybe be without the pillar. So we could just plank it in front of a building or something. Or in case of my coal mine, maybe make a gantry over the entire thing. The thing is that I have a lot of sidelines, and some of them are there for specific purposes. So it would be really nice if I could just build a big old gantry going over all of these. And then just have signs attached to the top that are over the different text to show their purpose. So this would be the one where I just have stake cars for the beams. This would be the one for stake cars for the rails. This would be coal collection. This would be for the for just the train that is there already. However, that's also another thing that I wanted to show here, which is why I'm here right now. I made the Lookout Express, which I think we are going to take a ride on in the next episode. Just to have a bit of a more cinematic kind of thing going on. So I decided to just take a few pops here in order to build a little station. Also again another Undertaker workshop. And the purpose of this thing is to first go up to the coal mine in the mountains. And from there there's a whole another new track that continues further up the mountain and to the very top. I was actually considering on even removing the entire thing again once I maybe showed it off one time, but I think right now it's looking a lot better than it used to. The problem is I need a lot of switchback, especially once the entire track gets further and closer to the top, where the entire mountain narrows down, so you need a lot of switchbacks, and there's not always a nice area available to build them on, so some of it is kind of mid-air and just ending there. Looked a bit weird, but I think I found a decent enough solution to keep it around, and I'm especially proud of this little building that I have here. I think it's kind of cute. So anyways, that's gonna be it for this video. I'll be using this train in the next one because, yeah, it would otherwise be a very, very long episode. So, till then, thanks for watching, and I hope you enjoyed. Bye-bye, till next time.